the CTBP is one of the larger consumers of computing resources we have on campus.
The purpose of the center is to look at problems of biological systems, living things, and how can the study of those things teach us new ideas in physics.
High-performance computing is a large part of the research that the CTBP group carries out. They do primarily molecular dynamics simulations, and these simulations can scale quite large.
Really, in a way, a living cell is a computer. You really have to deal with huge amounts of information and figure out how information is processed.
In other fields, you may have a microscope or a telescope or something like that. In this case, right, their instrument is the computer.
The kind of rule of thumb is you never have enough computing power. We're at the stage now where we actually have a very good model that we could simulate things on a much larger scale, but it would take a really long time on a conventional supercomputer. But on state-of-the-art GPU machines, it opens up orders of magnitude more performance.
So when we bring a new system on board, there's quite a lot that goes into it beyond simply just, you know, integrating the system and connecting things together. So there's a continuous discussion both with AMD as well as with the integrators to make sure that we have all the information we need, that problems can get answered. The really valuable and very important component of the donation is the continued support from AMD, providing a forum where researchers can collaborate.
One of the problems we did a few years ago and started to do is to look at the influenza virus and try to understand how the influenza virus invade your cell. So as a natural thing, when COVID came around, they tried to understand what's the mechanism for the COVID virus to invade. And that's a very complex problem because this is a much more complicated virus, it's much larger, the proteins are much larger. So in our case, when the AMD machine appeared, that really speed up the process. We can actually now start to explore the entire surface of the spike protein. All these things become game changers.
You have data, you think about it, it stimulates new questions. It's that development of questions that makes the great scientist.
I just want to have the fun of doing science.
We're not trying to do some particular commercial venture, but we're able to sort of go where our curiosity takes us.